In this case study, the challenge is to create a series of ribs that straddle this cylindrical face. Without the use of workarounds, such as overlapping extrudes or deleting faces. Let's start with the center rib. Create a sketch on the right plane. We will be creating a line to be used in the rib command. At this point, there is nothing for the line to snap onto. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. We will select these two faces. These two lines represent the intersection between the sketch plane and the selected faces. Now we can snap the endpoints of the line onto these two projected lines. This is now a closed profile. Take note that the rib command does not actually require a closed profile. Just to prove this, let's change the projected lines to construction. Go to Create, Rib. Select the sketch line as the curve. For thickness options, let's set it as symmetric so that the thickness will extend equally on either side of the line. For depth options, select to next. The command will automatically look for faces for the rib to terminate against, which in this case will be the cylinder and the base. Adjust the thickness. As we increase the thickness, notice how the rib adjusts and extends up to the cylindrical face. Sometimes you might need to flip the direction if the feature doesn't look right. Even when the cylinder diameter changes, the rib command would always terminate exactly up against the cylindrical surface, no more, no less. Next, we need to create a series of ribs. As we move sideways, the distance between the original termination point of the rib and the cylindrical face increases. The obvious question here is whether the patterned features would also extend up to the cylindrical face. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. For Type, select Features and click on the rib. For direction, click on the select box and select the x-axis. We want the pattern to be symmetrical about the original rib, so select symmetric as the direction type. Adjust the quantity and distance. For compute option, let's try optimized for a start. When you examine the end result, you can see that the patterned ribs do extend up to the cylindrical face. If you try the other two compute options, you will get the same result. This is a pretty robust workflow. You can adjust the cylinder size, wall thickness, rib thickness, or even a rib quantity, without breaking it. Of course, if you extend the pattern beyond the cylinder diameter, it will fail, but this is something that is to be expected. For the sake of comparison, let's perform an overlapping extrude on the other side. We need to somehow constrain this edge. Let's use the intersect command to create a projected line here. Connect the tip of the triangle to the center point of this line. You will know that you have snapped onto the center when the triangle appears. Make this line vertical. This is to make sure that the extrude always stays between the inside and outside faces of the cylinder. When you are ready to do the extrude, you would have to work out a way to control the thickness of the rib, such that it does not protrude out of the cylindrical surface. Some sort of formula might be required to do that. So as you can see, to get even close to the level of control of the rib command, there is a substantial amount of work to be done. Let's perform the pattern. I was pleasantly surprised that the optimized option actually works. The patterned features do extend up to the cylindrical face. Take note, however, that if we adjust the compute option to identical or adjust, the rib does not extend up to the cylindrical face. Let's change it back to optimized and try changing the cylinder diameter. As you can see, it holds up pretty well. However, I will still encourage users to adopt the rib command, as that is a workflow that gives users the most flexibility without the burden of having to manually constrain extrudes.